So, you've done a little bit of kickboxing, you've done nothing.
Yeah.
Have you ever had to defend yourself, say your life is real?
No. Actually, I punched a guy out.
Punched a guy out, I like you.
In an airport.
Yeah, how was that? That's awesome, how was that?
Stand up, I'll show you what happened. I was just standing, that's me.
Okay.
And this drunk little guy came up and just grabbed me by the balls, so I just did an uppercut. And the police came and just took him away. Now, I have a feeling he was drunk enough that if I'd gone bing, he would have fallen. But when we got back home, we had to reenact this for our spouses because it was exciting then.
Was there anything said before he grabbed you? Did you do anything?
No, I remember he was sort of blowing smoke on people and stuff. He was just being obnoxious, you know?
Just an obnoxious asshole.
Yeah.
Okay.
I've worked in the bar and stuff, but when you say it, I end up being kind of...
But you've seen fights.
No, I've been involved. I've broken up.
Oh, you've broken up.
I've kicked people out. I've wrestled people to the ground. Okay. I'm not afraid of getting...
Okay.
I mean, I wasn't afraid of my life, but
no,
I just...
No.
I don't like
no,
people
yeah.
bugging me.
Please don't touch me.
All right. Okay, that's great. That's great that you... both been there because it's very important and you can kind of understand and differentiate between martial arts and real life self-defense, which is a huge difference.
Mm-hmm.
So no matter like whether it's kickboxing, whether it's jiu-jitsu, wrestling, whatever, you can take that and put it into the arena of a real competition. And you know, that's the reason martial artists get beat up in street fights, mugged and killed or whatever, is because their system is actually their downfall. What I mean by that is they train to defend against prearranged attacks. And for those attacks, they have prearranged defenses for those attacks. So someone throws a right punch, you are to step off to the side and bring your arm up like this, grab one, two, three, knee, elbow, like whatever, throw to the ground this way. So you have a five-step, six-step technique against a prearranged attack. And another problem is with martial arts is they think about a fight that's, it's purely physical, but it's not. There's a huge behavioral element to a fight. By behavioral, I mean fear management, adrenaline management, establishing your state of mind at a time, just accept what's happening and deal with it in that moment. Because if you go, this can't be happening, this can't be happening, this can't be happening, it's going to happen. Because the bad guy controls what's going on, you don't control the fight. It's the bad guy picked it. You picked you as a potential target, you've been the target, now he's going to initiate his move. So you have no choice but to kind of accept what's happening, is to establish a state of mind and go forth from there. So a lot of martial arts don't deal with establishing your state of mind and mindset that's needed to survive. They only deal with physical technique. And a physical technique can be done by anybody. It's the rage and ferocity behind the technique, the physical attack that most people freeze. Just the language, the look in their face, the ferocity behind their physical attack. Because if I just come up and I grab somebody and just go like this and do nothing, anybody can defend against that. So, and with training with Senshido, we replicate scenarios as closely as possible to real life. You're going to learn all your physical moves, but I don't teach techniques. I don't teach someone throws a right punch, you do this. Someone grabs you with two hands, you do this. What I do is you develop your tools, your palm strike, your elbow, your headbutt, a knee, whatever it might be, whatever the strike might be, defending a takedown, fighting from the ground, accessing a weapon during the fight, something like that. A tool that you can use to defend yourself with. Not a memorized one, two, three, four step technique. Okay.
I'm just saying that sounds very practical.
Yeah.
If you need something to defend yourself, then I think that's.
It's like by a tool, think of a hammer, okay? It can be used to drive a nail, pull a nail, pry two pieces of wood apart, smash somebody in the head. It can be used as a bunch of different things, but it's just a hammer. So if you think of a palm strike, it can be used to hit somebody in the face. Once you hit them in the face, you can go into an eye gouge or whatever. It opens itself to a lot more possibilities than a fixed technique. So I'm not going to be teaching you fixed moves because they don't work. Because when you're in a fight, I've had experience with a lot of altercations, I've had to save my life 4 or 5 times. I've had to save myself a beating ahead of time. Okay? So I'm telling you, when you get into a fight, you're not going to memorize anything. You're going to be able to utilize your tools because they'll become second nature to you. The reason they'll become second nature to you is because with Senshido, I'll train you to enhance what evolution has given you as a human being to defend yourself. So you already have it. Like everyone has a will to survive, so to speak. If you're getting attacked and someone's trying to kill you, you're going to fight back. Depends on, you know, a lot of people, it'll depend on how hard they'll fight back, depending on their mindset and their personalities, and how they've been brought up, like everything, it'll depend on that. But evolution has given us tools and concepts and everything to defend ourselves with. So why not enhance that? You go to a martial arts school and they deprogram everything that evolution has given you as a human being. I mean, it's a good exercise. It builds self-esteem, self-confidence. If you want to compete in tournaments, that's great, but it's not going to save your life. So what Senshido is going to do is I'll teach you to defend yourself using what evolution has given you for a human being. I'll give you analytical skills and physical tools that will be useful in any situation rather than a technical application like a karate block and then a 1-2-3-step technique for specific attacks. So if I give you concepts and skills that you can use in any situation, you can adapt to anything. You're not going to required to memorize a physical, complicated move. You're going to be, you know, if you're fighting one opponent, two opponents, whether they have a weapon or not, whether it's in your car, so there's a home invasion, someone's in your bed, whether someone's trying to rape you, mug you, beat you, you'll be able to defend yourself using the exact same concepts and skills as you would anything else. Okay, that's a good question that Michelle asked, you can put it up there. Because let's say this is going to be a basic concept I'm going to try to get across. Okay, this is a common physical attack that you can face. A knife at the throat can be a knife to my stomach, a knife to my testicles. The knife can be held this way, the knife can be held this way, the knife can be held this way. So martial arts will say, okay, if the knife is held this way, I want you to, I'm just going to make some shit up. Okay, so I want you to step across. And I want you to grab this, and I want to hit them here twice, and I want you to grab it. And it's just, that's not. But if the knife is held this way, then you can't do that anymore. Now you have to do this. But if the knife is held this way, no, that won't work. You have to do it this way. So, Michelle has the knife lower. So, Michelle has a knife in my throat. Okay? So, a concept that you have to remember is don't move the knife across your center line. This is my central line here. I don't want to move the knife across my throat, basically. Okay, if I disarm the knife this way, there's a greater chance of increasing me getting cut in the throat rather than this way. Okay, but if the knife is here, the same concept applies. Don't cross the center line. So the blade is this way, it's not going to go the other way. But the physical technique in disarming is I'm not going to be able to disarm Michelle with just by grabbing this because, okay, so I'm just going to play a mock scenario. I'm going to play it kind of like downplayed a bit, okay? But if someone has a knife in their throat like this, they're not just going to stand here. First of all, there's the behavior element you have to be aware of. So if I want to get Michelle's money, if I want her car, if I want to rape her, if I want to beat her, or whatever. Okay, so if I want her money, I'm not going to hold the knife here and stand like this and not say anything, because that doesn't happen. So this is where the behavioral element of the attack will come in. This is the physical part. Easy to deal with, relatively. And this knife is dangerous, you'll probably get cut. But it's not. It's not the attack, so to speak. The attack. Give me one fucking bitch right now. I'm gonna fuck my head. Okay. That's the attack. And if you can't, and she was like flinching, like trying to push it away. And if you can't deal with the language and the behavioral aspect, that's the toughest part. This is easy.
Because you're just
yeah, this is simple. But if it's combined with me, I'm like, and I'm like this. And the knife, and you have to remember a static knife attack, is what we call a static knife attack, because it's held somewhere on your body. It's never inherently always static. The knife might move here, might move to her stomach, whatever. It might move to her eye like I did like that. So it's much safer than dealing with a guy that's just trying to pump the knife in you. But what I'm trying to show you is what is combined with that physical move. So the attack, that's the toughest to deal with, is the behavioral side of things.